zostałem zapytany, jaką mógłbym udzielić wam radę, jeżeli zaczynacie dopiero karierę frontendową. Gdybym ja teraz musiał zaczynać od początku, myślę, że zrobiłbym to tak samo, jak zrobiłem wcześniej, czyli nie przejmował się tym, że jest bardzo dużo frameworków, bardzo dużo technologii, wszystko się zmienia, tylko znalazł sobie niszę, która mnie interesuje i się jej trzymał. W moim przypadku był to backend w Node, którego używałem przez rok i później zacząłem od Reacta, Reacta Native.
So if I was starting to be a front-end developer right now, I'd be terrified, right? Because there's a million and one frameworks that people think they have to learn. Everything changes so quickly that it's just kind of scary.
I would probably start by trying to find some mentors. So people that I have seen the work they do and also put out content and try and learn from these people.
I would just start with just some HTML, some CSS, and some JavaScript. Start there and build up like that foundational knowledge. And only once you get kind of comfortable with the underpinnings of that, then start looking at what those other tools are.
I mean, I need to learn practically, so I need to actually do the thing to learn a thing. So I'd like to think I could go to a course, but I very much doubt if I'd learn that much. What I would do is try and find an online course where I can actually code examples and go from there.
Like if you understand the core technology and how it all works, you can hop between React and Angular and Vue or Ember or whatever it happens to be pretty easily. You just have to, you know, read the docs and understand the decisions they're making, but it's a lot easier to move about that way.
So my honest advice to anyone starting now would be learn about the history of the web. So Jeremy Keith's got a great book called Resilient Web Design, which talks more about the fundamental concepts of the web and introduce things like progressive enhancement. And those are things that are really important to learn regardless of what framework you use or whether you use SAS or LESS or post-CSS.
First, you have to decide which of the latest and greatest you want to learn. But then you get stuck on all the different opinions that that framework is making on your behalf, and you end up never having the awareness of the underlying stuff. So then, you know, what happens a month later or 2 months or whatever it happens to be, and that framework's not being maintained or it falls out of favor and it's tough for you to move to something else. But if you've got that core understanding, you're always going to be okay.